Hello dear friends, the order Diptera is to be discussed today, and the members of this order, the families Cecidomidae, Tripetidae, Tachytidae, Agromyzidae are the ones which we say they are the representatives of this order Diptera. So the etymology is that it is having two words, that is di, it is two, and tera means wing. This means it is having just two wings. In the earlier part we have seen the modifications of the wings of these insects, either they are called as halters. So they are having just a pair, means it's a pair of mesothoracic wings is functional. Now the common names, the true flies, the mosquitoes, the gnats and the midges, they are the common names that we have regarding, or they are representing this order Diptera. Now what are the characteristics? Let us see one by one. They are small to medium sized soft bodied insects. The body regions are distinct. Then the head is often hemispherical and attached to the thorax by slender neck. Neck is small. Then the mouth parts are of sucking type but may be modified. As in the case of houseflies, we have seen that it is spongy type of mouth. Then all thoracic segments are fused together. The thoracic mass is largely made up of mesothorax, small lobe of the mesonotum, that is scutellum. As we know, in the note there is pre-scutum, scutum and third scutellum. In this mesonotum, the scutellum overhangs the base of the abdomen. Next is, they have a single pair of wings. As the name suggests of this order Diptera, there is a single pair of wings. The forewings are larger, membranous and used for flight. Means the single pair, what we know, is used for flight. The hindwings are highly reduced, knobbed at the end and are called as halters. They are rapidly vibrated during flight, and the function of the halters is to maintain an equilibrium. So they are the organs of equilibrium, means while the insect is in flight, they are acting for balancing the flight, also called as balancers. Halters are also called as balancers. Then the flies are the swiftest among all the insects. Now the metamorphosis is complete, so we can say that they are the representatives of Endoterygota. The larvae of more common forms are known as maggots. So the flies that we know, the true flies, their larval stage is called as maggots. They are apodous. Apodous means they are not having legs. The larval stage is not having the legs, and they are acephalous, means cephala is called as head. So they are not having the head. The mouth parts are represented as mouth hooks. In the larvae, the mouth hooks are present, which are attached to the internal sclerites. The pupa is generally with free appendages and often enclosed in the hardened last larval skin called as puparium. So all of you are knowing that there are three types of these pupal stages. In case of optic type, they are fused inside. Then in exarate type, they are extended outside. And in case of coarctate type, as in the case of these order Diptera, they are having the last larval skin called puparium, and this puparium encloses the insect inside. Okay, the pupa belongs to the coarctate type. Then the classification. Here these orders, three suborders are there in order Diptera. First is Nematocera, then second is Brachycera, and third is Cyclorapa. Nematocera, Brachycera, and Cyclorapa. So Nematocera, it is thread horn, antenna is long and many segmented in the adults. The larval head is well developed. Larval head is well developed. We can also say that there are some eucephalus type of heads here. The larval mandibles act horizontally. The pupa is weakly obtect. Weakly obtect. Then the adult emergence is through a straight split in the thoracic region. The thoracic region splits and the adult emerges out from the pupa. As all of us know that there is a ectodiscal cleavage line through the head and it breaks open till the thorax. Then second suborder, Brachycera, it is short horn. The antennae is short and few segmented in adults. The larval head is retractile into the thorax, means the head of larva that we know it is maybe acephalus or eucephalus, but it is retracted or taken back or can be hidden in the thorax. The larval mandibles act vertically. There is vertical axis for its movement and activity. Then the pupa is exarate, means its body parts, the appendages, they are just left outside the case of that pupa. The adult emergence is through a straight split in the thoracic region, same as in the Nematocera. And third is, third suborder, Cyclorapa. It is circular cracking. Here the antennae is aristate in the adults, as we have seen in the flies. Then the larval head is vestigial with mouth hooks. Larval mouth hooks act vertically. And the pupa is co-arcted, means it is having a puparium, means the last the skin, you call it as the cuticle, it is going to prepare the pupae of these cyclorhamphans. It is co-arcted. Thus Cyclorapa, where the co-arcted pupa has circular line of weakness along which the pupal case splits, just like a cap, it opens up and the adult emerges out of that. The split results due to the pressure applied by an eversible bladder, a bladder type or bladder like appearance or part is present in the head, and that bladder is having pressure exerted on the external pupa, and it breaks out, and that pupa, the bladder inside that pupa or inside the head, it is tylinum. That bladder is called as tylinum. So we'll discuss the suborders with the families now, which are the representatives of these suborders. First suborder, Nematocera. Here first family is Culicidae. Now the members of this Culicidae family are the mosquitoes. They are fragile, delicate, and slender insects, means their size is small. The females have piercing and sucking type of mouth parts with six stylets. There are six stylets in the mouth parts of these mosquitoes. Always remember this. And in other kinds of phytophagous insects, you may see there are four stylets only. Okay, then the antenna is plumose type in males. Male mosquitoes have plumose type of antennae, and in female the type of antenna is pilose type, means it is less hairy. Plumose is bushy and pilose type of antennae, it is less hairy. As you can see, the you know, the plant like bottle brush, how its flowers are, the arrangement of flowers, it represents the plumose type of antennae. Okay, then the legs are slender, delicate, and long. The wings are fringed with hairs and scales on hind margin and on some veins. Okay, there are fringe and hair. Then the males are short-lived and feed on the nectar or decaying fruits. Means you can see here that the male mosquitoes, they are not biting for the blood. This work is done by the females, and they are short-lived and they are just eating away, or they are surviving on nectar or decaying fruits. The females live long and are feeding on the blood, so this blood is utilized by the females for the purpose of getting their eggs matured. The larvae of mosquitoes, called as wrigglers, this is a very important objective and a question many a times appears in some exams. Then the larval head is large with chewing mouth parts and mouth brush aiding filter feeding. Thorax is large without legs, no legs are present, there is apodous. Respiratory siphon is located in the penultimate abdominal segment, as we have discussed earlier in the types of respirations. Anal gills are present at the terminal end of the abdomen. Then the pupa of this Culicidae is known as tumbler. So the pupa of mosquito is called as tumbler. The larva is called as wriggler. Pupa is called as tumbler. It is very active. It has a pair of prothoracic horns, which houses the anterior pair of spiracles. Anterior pair of spiracles are present there in the prothoracic horns. A pair of anal paddles is present at the terminal end, which aids in swimming. It helps in swimming. The two types of mosquitoes you can see in the photograph. On the left side, it is malarial mosquito, and its name or the genus is Anopheles. And on the right side, it is filarial mosquito, the genera Culex species. It transmits filariasis. So malarial mosquito, Anopheles; filarial mosquito, Culex. You can see their appearance and their feeding habit. Okay, so on the left side, in this, you can see the photo of the extended larva, and this larva is called as wriggler. And on the right side, this pupa of a mosquito called as tumbler. So this is wriggler and this is tumbler. Then family Cecidomidae, they are the gall midges, minute delicate mosquito like flies. The antennae are long and also the legs are also long. The wing venation is reduced. The wings are covered with long hairs. A dark sclerotized area is present mid-ventrally on the prothorax. Mid-ventrally on the prothorax in the larva, called the chest bone. Here you can say the mid-ventral side. Mid means in the center and ventrally means on the lower side. On the prothorax means on the lower side, or just beneath its body. You can see a chest bone, okay, and it is dark sclerotized area. So the rice gall midge example. These are the midges which are feeding in rice crop, and they are producing the galls. Okay, and the example or the scientific name of this is Orciolia oryzae. Orciolia oryzae, and on the right side you can see the maggot of this gall midge. Then suborder Brachycera, family Acylidae, in which you have the examples like the robber flies. Acylidae family and example is robber flies. They are elongate bristly flies. Head is broad and hollowed out in between the compound eyes. Then the compound eyes are protuberant, means they are just bulged one. A prominent tuft of hairs is found on the head, forming the mouth beard. Means the name suggests a robber. It just shows such appearance, which is somewhat scary. Then the proboscis is thick and stout. Legs are stout, hairy, and suited for catching the prey. Means from this you can know that they are predators. They catch the prey. The abdomen is tapering and has a pair of large claspers at the tip of male and a horny ovipositor in female. They are more active, non-selective predators. Very active and non-selective. Whatever they get, they can feed, they can attack and prey on it. So this is example of robber flies. How it looks? It looks dangerous. Then Tabanidae, the horse flies, in which the body is stout, head is large, eyes are large and often brilliantly colored. Horse flies, you might have come across this pest, and it sucks the blood from our cattle. Okay, in males the eyes are holoptic, contiguous. In female, dicoptic, means separate. Holoptic and dicoptic we have seen in case of the dragonflies and damselflies. So here also, in case of males, the eyes are holoptic, and in females they are dicoptic. This is you may say the separate, or you may say you can identify them as males and females. Then the third antennal segment is annulated. The proboscis is strong and pointing downwards. They are swift flyers, means their movement is fast. The male feeds on nectar. The male feeds on nectar, and the females, they are sucking the blood from the cattle and horses. And one more thing, they are vectors of a disease called as anthrax in the cattle. So this is horsefly. Family Tabanidae. Then suborder Cyclorhapa. Family Sylphidae. These are the hoverflies and flowerflies. Brightly colored and brilliantly striped. Their color is bright and there are stripes, means just strips, or you may say zebra like markings. A vein like thickening, that is a spurious vein, is present in between the radius and median in the forewing. A vein like thickening is there in between the veins, the radius and media or median in the forewing in Sylphidae. The next point is abdomen has distinct black and yellow markings. Abdomen is with distinct black and yellow markings. The maggots play prey on soft-bodied insects, especially the aphids. So these Sylphid flies, they are the biocontrol agents that lead to the management of aphids in our crop. The adults are excellent flies or flyers, and they hover over the flowers. They feed on pollen and nectar and help in pollination. So the hover flies and flower flies, the family Sylphidae. Then family Tephritidae. In this family we have the worst pests of our fruit crops, and they are the fruit flies. The subcosta bends apically. Subcosta means the second vein in the wings. The subcosta bends apically and fades out. The wings are spotted or banded. There may be some spots or there may be bands. On the examples that you can see on the lower side, the photos, they show the spots and bands. Then the female has a sharp and projecting ovipositor for egg laying. They are cutting through the parts or the skin of the fruit and they are laying their eggs. For that purpose, the ovipositor is sharp. The maggots can hop, means they can jump. They are highly destructive to fruits and vegetables. The cucurbit fruit fly is an example, and many examples are there from this family Tephritidae, which contains the fruit flies. Here the representative is Dacus cucurbitae. You may have many other examples known while you are studying the crop pest. The next is family Drosophilidae. They are also called as vinegar gnats, pomace flies. Their eyes are usually red and they are attracted to rotting vegetables and fruits. The larvae feed on yeast and products of fermentation. So the yeast are responsible for fermentation. They are feeding on the yeast and this yeast producing the product is fed upon. Then the life cycle is very short, almost only 7 days. And all of you are acquainted with this name, Drosophila melanogaster, regarding your studies of genetics. So the pomace fly, the Drosophila melanogaster, they are extensively used in the study of animal genetics. Here you can see the photograph of these males and females of Drosophila melanogaster, and the life cycle is given. After mating, they are having the embryo, then first, second, third instar, then a pre-pupa, then pupa, and at last the adults. Then family Tachinidae, in which there are tachinid flies. The arista is completely bare. Arista is completely bare, means the antenna is bare without the bristles. Then the abdomen is stout with several noticeable bristles, and they are non-specific endoparasites on the larvae and pupae of Orthoptera. They are non-specific endoparasites, or they are living inside the body of organisms, okay, on the larvae and pupae of Orthoptera, Hemiptera, Lepidoptera and Coleoptera. So they are the friends of farmers, you may say, which will lead to the management of the pests from the order Orthoptera, Hemiptera, Lepidoptera and Coleoptera. You can see the life cycle of these flies, and the adult laying the eggs on the body of a looper, and it gets dead later on. Then family Musidae, or known housefly, antenna is aristate, or the arista is plumose. Mouth parts are smaller. The labium is distally modified into a pair of oval shaped fleshy lobes called labella. So sponging type of mouth part having fleshy lobes called labella, and this labella is having pseudotracheae, which is utilized for sucking the food or liquid food, or it gets that food with the action, or like a sponge, it will just suck in the food. Then the pretarsus consists of two claws and two adhesive pads. There are adhesive pads in the or in between the claws. Then the first abdominal segment is yellow in color. First abdominal segment is yellow in color. The terminal abdominal segments are telescopic, forming a pseudo ovipositor. The abdomen is not bristly on basal part. Telescopic means it is retractable. Okay, terminal abdominal segments, they are retractable, forming a pseudo ovipositor. And the maggots are scavengers, means these scavengers are responsible for eating away some dead material, dead and decaying material. The adults carry certain disease causing microbes on its legs, body, hair and mouth part. And house fly that we see, we are generally having in our place, they are the common house flies, Musa domestica, family Musidae, Musa domestica. This is house fly. The next is Hippobosidae. The body is flat and leathery. The legs are short, strong and useful for clinging to the host. They cling to the host. Then the wings are present or absent. Family Hippobosidae, wings are present or absent. They are viviparous. They are viviparous, means the reproductive ability is that they can give birth directly to the larvae. So they give birth to mature larvae which are glued on the hairs of the host. They are viviparous, means they are saving the time on getting the eggs incubated and hatched. This activity is completed inside the body of the adult only, the adult female. The young larvae is retained in a special uterine pouch and nourished by special nutritive glands after hatching out. And the larvae, once laid, never feeds. It pupates immediately. Means after it is laid on the body of the host, that larva will directly pupate, and after emergence, it will be a free-living adult. They are blood-sucking ectoparasites on the cattle and dogs. All of you are knowing this. They are blood-sucking ectoparasites on cattle and dogs. Example, Hippobosca maculata is associated with cattle, and Hippobosca capensis is parasitic on the dogs. So these are all the suborders and families of order Diptera, wherein they are having their metamorphosis complete, and the larval stages called as maggots, and in case of the mosquitoes, the larval stage is called as wrigglers, and their pupa stage, it is a coarctic type of pupa, and the mosquito pupa is called as tumbler. So let's finish this. Take care.